Hey, this is Matt. Happy Thanksgiving. Happy Day of Gratitude. I wanted to send you this video and share with you an important concept about gratitude and just to give you a big hug over the internet here, give you a big wave of love and say how much I am grateful for you, how much I appreciate you. Being a part of this community, we have an amazing community of people who are dedicated to increasing love in the world, people who are dedicated to aligning with that vibration of love and being a greater presence of love. And I appreciate that in you. And so this being a day of gratitude, it's an interesting concept to think about when you think about gratitude, because there are things in our life that are easy to feel grateful for, aren't there? Your loved ones, health, the good health that you have, the house that you live in. Like, we can bring our mind to things that are easy to feel grateful for. But I have found that while that's easy in our lives to do, some of the most powerful gratitude practice that you can actually generate is to generate gratitude for the things that aren't so easy to feel grateful for. And so in life, there are things that happen to us. In life, there are things that we would prefer didn't happen. So think about something in your life right now that you may not have wanted to happen to you, something that you feel you're resistant to in your life. And the question is, how do we generate gratitude for that? Because if we can generate gratitude for those things, then we can more easily return to love, more easily return to peace. You know, one of the most impactful events of my life where I really resisted what was happening was in high school football. I was a talented football player. My dream was to play college football. And as a sophomore in high school, I blew out my knee really bad. And I remember laying in the doctor's office the night, I've still got my football uniform on and they cut through my pants and the doctor's got my knee and he's literally doing this with my knee. And I remember the doctor looking at me and saying, son, I don't think you're ever gonna play football again. You know, get ready to give that dream up. And it felt like someone stabbed me in the heart with a knife. Tears streamed down my face. And I remember being so angry at God in that moment. I was so angry. I felt like God ripped that dream right out of my clenched fingers. I had trained, I had prepared, I had worked my tail to the bone. My whole reason for going to school, for training hard, was for football. At that time of my life, that's what I was most passionate about. And so I sank into a depression around this. I felt so sad and so crushed about not being able to play football again. And so think about something in your life. What's something that's happened to you that evoked that painful experience? It might be someone left you. It might be someone betrayed you. It might be a loss that you've experienced in your life. How do we generate gratitude for that? How do we move to a place of non-resistance, move out of that resentment and into more of a place of peace? Well, I want to share with you a concept. It's an ancient Japanese philosophy called Kintsugi. Kintsugi literally means golden joining. And specifically, it comes from a Zen Buddhist practice of ceramics. And they believe that when a cup or a bowl was broken, that there's a process that you could go through where you actually take resin and mix it with powdered gold and then paint the lines of whatever was broken and rejoin it together. And it was a symbol of reconciliation from a broken past. Symbol of reconciliation from the resentment, from the anger. And here's what they believed, that when you would take a bowl that had been broken and you pour into it gold, something of high value, and you bring it back together, that the art that was created by means of this actually became more beautiful than what would be considered a perfect bowl before. That it was in the brokenness that really the true beauty was revealed. That's a very powerful concept, and I believe it's a powerful concept not just for those bowls, but for you and for me in our human existence. That what if the places where we felt broken, what if the places where we felt betrayed, the places where we felt like something was taken from us, what if it was those things that actually helped reveal our true beauty, helped reveal our true fullness, helped reveal our true strength? Because I'll tell you what, it was through that process of me blowing out my knee that I had to access new parts of myself. I had to access a deeper level of strength, a deeper level of resilience than I had ever accessed before, because I was not gonna give up on my dream of being a football player. Just like you've got a dream in your heart, and no matter what happens for you, there's that place in you that isn't willing to give up, that place in you that's stronger than any circumstance, any condition, anything that you're facing, and you are not giving up on that because you're committed. You will have this dream in your life. Just as I was committed to my football dream, and I poured in and I trained, I had to find new humility in myself, new patience in myself, and new strength in myself. And with that, I was able to come back, and I was able to play and finish high school football, and I was able to go on and live my dream of playing Division I college football. And it was because of that that I am the person that I am today, because I found that strength and I developed myself. And I truly believe that I am a more beautiful, stronger, empowered version of myself today because of going through that painful injury back in high school. And so the same possibility exists for you and for me. You are more powerful today. You are stronger today. You are more beautiful today. You are more expanded today because of the broken parts of your past, because of the experiences you have endured, because of everything that you've gone through that is making you the amazing, incredible version of you that you are today. That is the power of the philosophy of Kintsugi. And that is what's available for you and I today, to take the things that have happened from the past and transform them into gratitude. So this day, let us be grateful for not just all the blessings that we have and the family and the love, but let us be grateful for our past. Let us be grateful for the things we have gone through, because it's made us the incredible people that we are today. Here is to you living your amazing life, and me saying to you, feel a big hug on this day of Thanksgiving, and I'll see you soon.